Today, I'm going to put you in somebody else's shoes. You are a pharmacist working in regional Australia. Your town has just been hit by a flood. You've come into work today to start the cleanup, but you've quickly been approached by several locals. One gentleman's been evacuated from his home. He forgot to take his medications and prescriptions with him when he left, so he hasn't had his tablets in a few days. He's asking if you think that it matters, if you can give him the medications. There's also a lady waiting. She cut her leg on something in the flood water. She's asking you to take a look at it. Can you give her a tetanus shot? You know the road to the doctor out of town is cut off, and you've heard the local hospital is totally inundated. It's going to take hours for these people to be seen. And maybe they won't wait that long. Maybe he will keep missing his medications, she'll get a leg infection, and then they'll both end up in hospital with even bigger problems. Your mind is racing. You don't know what to do. You aren't prepared for this. This is the scenario that my research hopes to improve. During disasters, our health systems become overburdened and unbalanced. On one side of the scale, we see large numbers of patients presenting to our hospitals. And on the other side, we can have reduced numbers of health professionals working. This imbalance stretches our resources and personnel to their absolute limits. So who can provide relief during these times? Pharmacists play an essential role in the everyday healthcare team, and their potential to contribute during disasters is huge. A recent review showed that up to 60% of these patients who present to health services after disasters require small interventions such as immunization, wound care, or ongoing supply of their prescription medications. These roles are already familiar to pharmacists in some capacity, but without appropriate training and support, pharmacists are underprepared and limited in contributing to their full potential. So this is the aim of my research, to develop recommendations on how we can enhance the preparedness of pharmacists to respond to disasters in their local communities. To do this, I've begun over the last few weeks by interviewing pharmacists. So far, they've told me they're not prepared. They know they can do more, they just need something. The next phase of my research will be to continue interviewing and surveying pharmacists, pharmacy organizations, and disaster health experts to find out what that special something is. And in the final stage of my research, I'll be bringing these results to an expert panel who will agree upon a set of recommendations on what needs to be done to prepare our pharmacists for disasters. These recommendations could lead to legislative change or support the development of a training program. So imagine now that you are once more that pharmacist standing in the aftermath of a flood, but this time you're trained, you're prepared, you know exactly what to do. You can help the people in front of you by not sending them to the emergency department. You can stop their small problems from becoming big, and you can help to restore the balance to your health community. Thank you.